good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, hey, hey. Here we are in, still in North Bay. This is what we're looking at right out of our window. Yeah, and it's been raining overnight over here. Yeah, a little bit drizzling still going on right now. Just as I was waking up, it was pouring down. But right now, it's good. Yeah, we are just about to get out of here. We just finished doing our pre-trip here, and now we are gonna get out of here in about, I don't know, 5 minutes. Now we'll be out of here. Yeah, that's about a little bit after 6 o'clock Central Standard Time. So yeah, we are getting up right after our 10 hours and getting out of here. We want to make it home Saturday earlier. That's the plan anyways. I might even just take 8 hours off next night and just trying to get home ASAP, right? Who knows? But yeah, I heard yesterday from Trucker 366, I believe he called himself, from Pennsylvania. Thank you for leaving a comment there in my video. That indicates that you are watching my videos as well. So thank you, I appreciate that. That means a lot to me. And I saw, yeah, that I hope this rain is coming your way. I was looking at the radar this morning here after I was reading your comment there. And yeah, definitely, it looks like you guys are getting rain today too. Like the clouds were over there too, so. Hope for the best. So hopefully your fire ban will be lifted here pretty soon and everything will start getting nice and green, right? That's the plan, right? You want to have everything nice and green for summer, right? That's looks much better anyways. But yeah, so let's get on down the road, and that's come and follow along with me today. So that's right here on my passenger seat, and let's look out of the window and let's see what kind of goodies we'll be able to show you today. Yeah. You'll see what I see. This is it, guys. Here we are, putting her in gear. Or we just did, anyways. Now it's time to get out of here. Get some awesome miles behind us today. That would be fantastic. I believe Nipigon is going to be our goal tonight, or maybe that Flying J just passed Nipigon. I haven't looked it up yet how far it is, but I'm pretty sure that's going to be our goal for tonight. Yeah, I think it's about just under 800 kilometers from Nipigon up to Steinbottom, and I don't know how much it is from there to Winnipeg, but so I know we can definitely make it around that area because I got 1795 kilometers to go to Winnipeg, and so in order to get some good miles in, I can easily do 1100 kilometers in one day. So, so we should only have about 700 kilometers left for tomorrow. So that means I could probably just perfectly make it up to that Flying J there before Thunder Bay. That would be fantastic. That way I can fuel her up there tonight. And then we'll get me a shower, right? That would be the plan anyways. Well, I might just fuel up in Captus casing too. You know, it's on the way here on Highway 11. I might just do that instead of waiting all the way till tonight, because well, realistically, I only have a little bit over a tank of, half a tank of fuel. And with having a little bit of a heavier load like I have today, it'd be a bit more challenging get to the truck stop there at just before Thunder Bay. So I time I just feel up there at the campus casing, and there is somebody that I know that's very familiar with that area, or actually a couple of people that are on my channel. They probably wouldn't mind seeing some of that area again. You guys haven't been here yet, I don't know, lately. I know a while back ago when I showed this area, you guys were saying that please show that area because we used to live in there and stuff like that, so we would love to see what it looks like today. I tried. And yeah, I don't know if you guys are still watching my video these days, but it would be kind of nice, kind of cool if you guys still did. But yeah, as you can tell, we definitely do have a heavy load today. She's a little hill like this, she's working hard. Yep, that's for sure. But I chose to go Highway 11 instead of Highway 17. The reason for that is because it's even way worse hillier up there on 17 than Highway 11. Now, I do know it is a little bit further around to go Highway 11, but I figured, you know what, the fuel that I'm probably going to be saving with going around here, it makes up easily for the amount of miles that it is further. I think it's about 40 miles further. And I said, I don't really care. I don't really want to work my engine and my truck so hard there going up that Highway 17. Unless I absolutely have to, right? So yeah, that's the plan anyway. So let's get on down the road and we will show you what we can, right? Alrighty guys, we are coming into New Liskeard, Ontario. That's right. And I don't know if you will be able to see it, but it's actually sort of ice drizzling or whatever you want to call it. Not sure exactly what you would want to call it, but yeah, I thought we were done with this stuff, but apparently not. You still have some ice drizzling and snow and stuff like that going on, and there's actually still some snow out here on the ground too. Yeah, indeed there is. Right now you can't see any, but out there in the field I can see some. Yeah, oh well. I guess that's the way it is. We got a little bit of a husky up here on the right, another little restaurant slash truck stop here to the left. A few truck stops here. A few places where you can stop when you got to stop, right? But other than that, it's a little tiny bit of a town up here. Yeah, past this there ain't too much going on. A few towns here and there, but not too much. Although we do have a scale coming up here in a few miles. Just outside of New Liskeard up here, there's a DOT scale. Yeah, hopefully they'll be closed. Today is Friday. What are you doing there, four-wheeler? Just have to pull over? Alright. I thought he was going to turn off, but then he just pulled over. Oh, okay. He just wanted to let me get past him. I guess he wanted to go a bit of a slower speed. Oh, well. I guess all I can say is thank you. Thank you for moving over so I can continue on cruising along here, right? Very nice guy, or gal, whatever it was. I didn't see what it was, but hey, I appreciate it. Oh man, let me tell you, some of these stretches are super rough. And I probably said that before, but some of them are okay, but
speed warning.
Most of them are pretty rough. Up here you can probably see the snow. Yep. That's what I was talking about. We still have some snow up here. It's only right around 0 to plus 1, which is right around 32, I guess, to 33, 34 degrees. Right around that freezing mark. So it's cold enough to where it can actually snow. But yeah, looks like the sky tail lights are out today. Just coming up to it here about now. Yeah, that's good. At least we won't have to go in there. Not that I'm worried about anything. I mean, I'm fine, but I kind of want to get in a lot of miles today, so I don't really want to waste any time out here. I want to just give her today. I don't even know if he's in there. I mean, I did see the DOT's vehicle on the other side, but he's on the fence in there, so that's, I guess, just in case he needs to get out somewhere or whatever, but no, he doesn't look like he's even in there. So that's cool. Yeah, we'll put the hammer down here and get in a few more miles. Well, guys, we are now leaving Cochrane. Ontario, that is. Yes, indeed, we are. I stopped here at that little subway truck stop, or I shouldn't say truck stop. Just that subway, they only have room maybe for about two trucks, that's it. Went inside and had me a subway sandwich. I was getting kind of hungry. So we are now making further progress to go home. We're already done 367 kilometers today. That's not bad. Yeah, but we got a long way to go yet. I think we got like 7 1/4 hours worth of driving to do yet before we will be done with today's day. Well, we're gonna go fuel up here in Captus Casey, which I believe is in about another hour and a half from here. And then I might just even go in there and take me a shower. I need a shower bad. I wanted to take a shower yesterday, but I could have gotten a shower probably there at the Petro Pass, but then I would have had to pay for it. And I knew I was going to be going past this Flying J yesterday already. So then I figured, I'll just wait till today. I'll stop in here and go take me a shower. So I might just do that. I don't even think I want to wait till the end of the day. I need a shower bad. Yes, indeed I do. But yeah. It was raining this morning, as you guys saw, and then it turned into a little bit of snow. And now we have sunshine. Cleared all up. Just absolutely gorgeous now. Starting to warm up too. It was like, got down to like -2 there earlier. So that's not good. I was kind of hoping we wouldn't be getting any of it. Well, luckily we didn't get enough of it to really worry about it. You know, like it wasn't even sticking to the ground. So that part was good. But yeah, here we are. Putting the hammer down again. And this is pretty much all you're going to get to see up here. A few towns here and there, and that's it. Other than that, you just see a 2-lane highway. Dry bushes, and that's it. At least right now. In summer, it's obviously going to be green, but considering it's still getting pretty cold over here at night, not much is getting green yet. But I think by the end of May, I think we should start seeing some nice green grass over here, trees and all that, so. But anyways, let's continue on rolling along here and see if anything jumps out today at us. Voila, guys and gals, here we are in Captus Casing. That's right. And we still have gorgeous sunshine. Yeah, we stopped there at the Flying J, I guess Shell/Flying J. is down the road from here. And yeah, we went in there first, fueled her up, cleaned our windshield because it was all a little white and dirty and stuff like that from salt. Because believe it or not, there this morning when it was snowing, I actually met a salt shaker and he was pouring some salt on the ground. So we had a bit of a white window. It was starting to get a little difficult to see in my mirror here on this side. So I had to go ahead and clean that all up, clean my headlights up in case we don't have any more stuff happening here till the evening. At least that way my lights are cleared, you know. But as you can probably tell, I went and had me a nice shower. Got clean clothes on now. Oh, that felt good. Now I feel like driving a million miles. Yeah, I don't know if that bad, but I feel good now. Refreshed. I definitely feel like driving now, that's for sure. But yeah, this is Captus Casing for you, ladies and gentlemen. We got a couple of traffic lights in here where we sometimes have to stop at. And so this is one of them. Got a Comfort Inn right here to the right there, that brown building up there. Yeah, not too much in here, but yeah, it's a nice little town, a little bigger than some of the other ones, you know. But not too big, not too big. Yeah, come on, light change already. There's nobody coming across that road, so you should have better sensors in there so the lights change quicker, you know. But yeah, well, I guess that's the way it is. I just don't want to block this road right here, so that's why I have so much space between me and that car. Because technically you're not supposed to block an intersection, right? Well, they got enough room that they can come onto the road. Yeah, that's right. So here we go. Now we got the green light, so we can be assured that we can get across this intersection, right? At least I think, anyways. Yeah, we cleared it now. Yeah, I guess that guy ahead of us there, he's probably pretty heavy, that's why he can't get up to speed very quickly. Or he's just choosing not to get up to speed very quickly, right? That could sometimes be the case too. Got a little bit of an auto slash truck repair parts up here, that yellow building. I do believe we have a Tim Hortons up here further down the road. Yeah, a couple of businesses in here. That's right. Well, what else would be new? We got a boat place here. I bet you they got some lakes up in this area. Well, I know for a fact they do. Because they got that big lake or river, whatever you want to call it up there. That's where they have a hydro dam. That's where we will be going by in a few. That's right. Yeah. We already got about a little more than 5 hours worth of driving behind us. And it looks like we got at least another 6 hours more to go yet. So it's gonna be a long day, but now we are set. We got our fuel, we got our shower, we had a bite to eat there in Cochrane. And so, don't really think we're gonna need to make another pit stop for a good while. We just might stop up there in Nipigon, because there's a Tim Hortons there, right? So we might go in there and grab us a cup of coffee. But then again, I might not, right? You never know. We'll just have to wait and find out, right? That's right. But anyways, let's get out of here and we'll show you what we can, right? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've been giving her a good, oh yeah, been getting some good miles in today. And we are just about to get into Nipigon, Ontario, that is. And we are on Highway 11, as I told you earlier yesterday, I believe, already. And this is what you see up here. Beautiful lake up here. Or a river, whatever the guys call it up here. But I like to call it a lake. But that's a fairly long stretch where we drive beside this lake up here. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna turn on the camera and show you guys, hey? How's that for scenery for you guys? I think that's just awesome. I like it. It's been a beautiful the rest of the day. It's been sunny all day long and not windy at all. I mean, you can't even see the trees moving or nothing. It's just an absolutely gorgeous day to be out here. I've had a fantastic day. I did have a burnt out tractor light.
Speed limit reduced ahead.
Yeah, before a little bit before I got up to Long Lac, we had a notification on my dashboard here, and that's where the Volvo, I like it the way they got it, is if you step on your brakes and your brake light happens to burn out or whatever, it sends you a notification right away, because it reads the voltage that you use, right? So as soon as that happens, then you get a notification. The same thing if your single light burns out or if your headlight burns out. The same thing. Even with the high beams or low beams, both of them have a sensor in them. So it was great. I know, I stepped on the brake, I was coming down a hill. Boom, I got the notification. I got a burned out brake light, it said. Well, it said check brake light. That's what it said. It didn't actually say burned out, but it said check brake light. So I stopped there in Long Lac, Ontario. And checked it, and sure enough, it wasn't working, so I replaced it. I mean, the running light was working, but the brake light, like you saw, it's got two, well, I guess it's one bolt, but it's got like two springs or whatever in there that you know, produces light. I don't know what the name for it is, but anyways, there's two of them in there, and one is for the single, the light, and the other one is just for the running light. The single light and the brake light is under one. So I checked it. Sure enough, it wasn't working. I had a spare one in the truck. I almost always do. But I went ahead and replaced it. And I had to reset the computer for it to recognize or do an assessment of it again. So I reset the computer. As soon as I did that, we were good to go. We had no more notification. And we were good to go. It's been working ever since. So yeah, that's one of the benefits of a Volvo.
In 1 kilometer,
they got all kinds of sensors.
Lake Superior Circle Tour.
They can tell you all these things, you know. I mean, mine is just a basic Volvo. It doesn't have a whole lot of sensors and stuff like that. It's very, very basic, but it still has some of these things, you know. So that's a nice little benefit about a Volvo. So you don't actually. You know, I always do check my brake lights anyways, but they were working fine this morning, right? All of a sudden, there just before long, like, you know, they went out. So it was nice of the computer to notify me, and I'm happy about that, so I was able to replace it. I mean, there's no DOT scales out here, but I like it to work too, you know? Just in case somebody comes from behind me and
meters. Keep to the
whatever,
right,
you know,
Lake Superior
an extra
Circle
light
Tour,
that
Highway
can work,
11.
Right? But enough of that.
In 300
we are just about to hit the Nipigon Bridge up here.
Circle
well, we're not going to hit the bridge, but we're going to drive over it, right? We're going to try anyways. So we'll try and show you that. See if we can refresh your memory. Looks like they got all kinds of construction going up over here. Looks like they're planning on doing something over here. They might be
11 kilometers.
Building a new bridge here pretty soon, or doing some upgrades here, that's for sure. Oh wow, that sun is probably going to be bright for you guys, so hopefully you guys are going to be able to see the bridge though. I know I've been showing this bridge a few times already lately, but ever since they had this bridge buckle there in winter, you know, everybody's talking about it,
construction,
and all that
ahead.
Stuff, so looks like they've gotten it all under control now. They put it back together. I guess they're saying it's safe to cross now. I mean, we were crossing here before too, but it was just one lane open, so this lane was the one that was buckling. Right about here, that's where it was buckling, or whatever, so... So yeah, they got that all under control now. So here we are. Gonna go into Nipigon. I stopped there in Long Lake, like I said earlier, so they have Robin Donuts in there. So I went in there and grabbed me a coffee in there. So I ain't gonna stop up here in Nipigon to get me a coffee, because we already had one coffee and that's good enough for me. So yeah. They got us probably about another hour before we get, or maybe a little less than an hour, but roughly around that, and then we'll be up there in that Flying J there just before Thunder Bay, and then we'll call it a day. That's gonna be it. Man, that sun is bright today, and it's coming right into my windshield. I'm sure you guys can see that in my my sunglasses. Yeah. But anyways, we'll get out of here, and then we'll talk to you guys a little bit later, which will be in a second for you guys, but we'll be right back, y'all. Well, guys, we are done for today. Yes, indeed, that's the case. I'm very happy too. We got a little bit over 1,000 kilometers. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it, but we are here at this Shell/Flying J. And I already closed that curtain because I am getting ready to get out of here. And we're gonna go jump in that bed over there. Uh-huh. And we're gonna get us a good night's sleep. And then we'll get out of here ASAP tomorrow morning, right? That is the plan anyways, so hopefully that will actually happen. So let's get to it. I hope you enjoyed today's vlog. I hope it was entertaining to you guys. And hey, sometimes my videos are just entertaining. Sometimes they're about scenery. Sometimes they can be educational. Every once in a while we do give tips out here. And every once in a while we give a shout out. Every once in a while we meet up with somebody. Some of my subscribers or maybe another YouTuber. You never know, right? It's all fun for me. I do this because I enjoy it. I do not do this to make money or to become famous. I do this simply because I enjoy sharing my daily life with you guys. And it makes me very happy when I see some good comments down there in the comments section. And you guys leave me some good comments and tell me, you know, that you liked the video or what part you liked about the video or and all that stuff. So that makes me feel good. I'm happy I'm able to create the content for you. I really do enjoy, like I said, making it for you. So if you enjoyed watching it, hey, give me a big fat thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, probably somebody of your friends or somebody on your Facebook page or whatever might like it too. So share the video on your social sites so that way you can help me grow. Not in this area here. I meant in the channel area. Yeah. With that being said, you guys know how the routine is. So we'll see you again tomorrow. Come 2 a.m. Central Standard Time. Remember, we're 7 days behind. So with that being said, goodbye, everybody. We'll see you right here on Trucker Rudy. It's time to get going. It's time to move on. Put this behind me. That day is gonna come.